In Western Europe, we've been sort of accustomed to a tradition of universalness of security based on sort of the old society with well-organized labor markets and a very, very high capacity to unroll social security in these countries. If we look forward, this may not be models that we have for keeps. It may actually be models that will be challenged or can be challenged by current developments. We see labor markets being much more varied in their composition. We see new types of labor developing, flexibilization. We see a dismantling of social security programs in some regions. And one particular point might be that in most European countries, social security is not sort of a public sector thing alone, but rather a multi-pillar thing with a something provided by the legislature through mandatory social security programs and other parts and bits supplied by collective agreements or other types of working arrangements. But the less influence or the less coverage the traditional formal type of labor market affiliation or labor market contract will have in these societies, the less efficient this old model will be. So there will be coverage issues related to the European community, just as there is for other regions in the world. But in the European context, it may be about having adequate and sufficient social security rather than the version of the coverage issue that will be relevant probably in an Asian or in an African or South American context, have access to social security in an absolute sense. For in the European region, it will probably more be about adequacy than coverage in an absolute sense. The growing importance of sort of non-standard employment relations will of course put new challenges or pose new challenges for social security. We need a social security system that fits the population that is there. It will never work the other way around. So we have to adapt social security to the realities out there in the economy, on the labor market, in the societies with which we're faced. And some of the groups that are particularly difficult would be the self-employed, would be migrating labor from working under contracts signed with companies maybe residing outside the country we may be talking about. The informal sector as well will be an issue as we move forward. And social security, sort of in its traditional sense, does not necessarily have all the answers as to how we're going to go about these challenges. So therefore, there will be some innovation to be done. There will be some new thinking to be done as to how can we unroll social security in a way that actually fits the realities out there.